Hi guys, so we're making a pork and beef soup today. I have my firecracker up on the stove. Let's just look at some of the ingredients. I have some turmeric dumplings, pumpkin for the base of my soup. I have some bodhi carrots inside there. For provision, I have sweet potato, edos, as well as green figs. Aromatics, I have carrots, garlic, onion, celery, shallot, benny, thyme inside there. I will be using cream style corn to help thicken it up nicely, and of course some spices inside here which I mix on my own. I have some fried rice seasoning which I think is brilliant inside of soup, some coconut milk also there, and I thicken up with ground split peas, and I use some oregano to the end. So let's
light up.
I always make my fresh beef tallow. This is a beef fat from scratch. As you can see, it's nice and soft. Look at that. Fresh fat from scratch. I don't usually buy oil again. I just use this. And would you believe these things are actually much healthier than oil to use it? Meanwhile, that's heating up. This is my pork and beef. I have them in nice cubes that I pre-cooked, so it's nice and soft, and it has that nice little sauce inside there which will be added to the soup also, that will add more flavor. Nice fat on there. Looks good. So at this point, when it gets nice and hot, everything from my sauteed tray goes inside here, including some bay leaf and some thyme. You want to mix that up nicely and get all those aromatics sauteed up. You want to let this cook for about 3 to 5 minutes to allow all those sugars to develop and caramelize. At this point, I want to add in my pumpkin. Let that mix up nicely inside there. And you know, you're developing the sweetness in the pumpkin also. All of this is going to blend shortly. So to that, now we add the water. Cream style corn goes in also. Okay, so we're going to be adding in 1 tablespoon of this fried rice seasoning. I have some black pepper. The idea is to mix everything together now. You're going to cover it and allow it to come to a simmer. Alright, so meantime, I have some coconut powder emptied up pack inside here. I also have this split pea powder I spoke to you guys about earlier on. We're gonna add some inside here also. And this is an excellent thickener and gives the soup body. And of course, coconut powder is gonna give a lot of great flavor. So to that now, we're gonna add some water. We're gonna mix that up nicely, just to incorporate both of them. Now we're gonna put this into the soup in a little while, just allowing those aromatics that we did earlier on to just harmonize and simmer, so all the flavors could merge, and we're gonna blend that, and then we're gonna, obviously this is gonna be inside. I think anyone who uses fresh seasoning, you'll cut these off and you plant them, and obviously we got side growing in the back of our yard, we don't waste these things, right? So I stuck them in already. Let me show you what it looks like. I have a little thing here growing, as you can see, shadow benny side, you know, random stuff. Great. Let's take a little peek here. As you can see, we've come to a beautiful simmer. This is what we want. We want to keep this for about 20 minutes to allow all the pumpkin to soften up, the garlic, the onions to really harmonize, and then we are going to then puree it. And to do that, to make my life easy, what I have is this. You all know this. Hand blender. I'll show you in a little while. All right, so about 10 minutes has gone by, and at this point in time, what I'm gonna do is add in that beautiful coconut and split pea mixture. So now this is going to then cook up inside here. Now keep in mind, all of this is gonna be blended in a little while, but this is gonna go for about 10 to 15 minutes again to allow everything to just harmonize and come together. What I need to do is just add a little bit of oregano inside there also. And this is going to weaken up as it simmers. It's going to allow those dry herbs to really become extra. All right, so this is what it looks like. I did take out the thyme and bay leaf, because we're going to blend it now.
This is so much simpler to do than put it in a blender.
Everything gets blended nicely. You get a beautiful base, that is the pumpkin, the split peas, the coconut, everything thickens up so nice. Carrots, the garlic, the onion, every aromatic that I place inside it becomes the body of the soup. So this is the base you end up getting, look at that. And you still say I get some beautiful carrot in the soup, but it's nice and thick now. Split peas, coconut, all the carrots, everything has blended up nicely. So you know when you get a mouthful of this, all those aromatics is a nice puree, it's thin, and it just melts on the palate. I get added split peas inside there also now. You get that nice viscosity and consistency going on. So this is where the fun starts to happen, all that pre-cooked pork and beef that goes inside here. All that nice sauce goes in there also. We let this join the party also, all the provisions, the sweet potato, edibles, green pig. Don't forget these guys, whatever vegetables you want. Nice carrots and bodhi, I like that. I got it growing right here, so I use it. All those turmeric dumplings, put them inside. Put the bay leaf back in and stir crazy now. Let everything just come together, let the dumplings cook, the sweet potatoes, the provisions, the meat. I mean, that meat has a lot of great sauce inside of it, it's going to make it special. And I'm really proud about how this is looking. You want to bring this to a nice simmer and let it go for about 20 minutes. The time has passed by and you're getting this nice little bubble, and pretty much this is good. All the dumplings are cooked through the provisions. You don't want to overcook them. Everything keeps its form. I mean, look how beautiful that looks. Such a beautiful sight. Look at that. All that nice beef and pork inside there. And this is pretty much done at this point in time. At this venture, I'll normally just add some black pepper and salt, taste it and see what it needs. But pretty much this is just natural flavor going on my beef and pork soup.